What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's Ronnie B on Paradise, and this is the new look that I'm going for. So if you have follow me on Instagram, that I have painted my room black, and it's super good. And I will give you a room tour soon. Like, I'm still waiting on few products, also some lights for the background. I'm still experimenting on this lighting, like the key light, where to place it, and the hair light, the background light. So anyway, we are talking about astrophotography today. Few months ago, I went to Oor. It's at Malappally. I went there to shoot two music videos for Organized Madness. If you haven't seen those videos, I will link the YouTube channel and those videos in the description below. Go check them out. Also give a follow. I'm playing with them, like, for live events sometimes when, like, And that day when I reached there, it was like evening, and I got the gear, went to room, packed everything, like all set up for the shoot in the morning. I went out just to have a random walk. I saw so many stars there, and I wanted to try astrophotography that day. So it was 9 or 10 p.m. at night, and I started taking shots, trying experimenting the shutter speeds, the aperture, the ISO. Like, I kept experimenting to get the best shot, and by 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, I started getting my results, and I'm gonna take you with me to that journey. I don't have that much details of the scene because it was like pitch black, and yeah, let's get into it. So before we start this shoot, I wanna give you guys two information. Okay, that's for two information. That's the time and place to shoot. Talking about time, yeah, you guys know, like, you have to shoot at night, but there are specific times. For example, there should be no clouds. It should be a moonless night, meaning new moon. So if you are shooting the moon, then you will need the moon. Like, if you are like solely relating and like shooting the stars, there should be no moon, because moon is kind of like a source of light, like a huge source of light when compared to the tiny stars. So it will give you a muddy, muted, blurry images, like too much light leak. So it should be a new moon day. So that's the time aspect and the place. So getting into where you should shoot. So you should be aware that you try not to shoot at cities or town areas, because there will be more light pollution. We need less light in the area. So if you are living in a town or city, if you go out and look at the sky at night, there will be like a cloudy area, like giving off light, kind of like a source of light from down to the sky. So we don't need that. So it's preferable if you go to a forest, not a forest, but a hill place or a countryside, there will be less light pollution and less light there, because there are less number of buildings and people there. So it's preferable you go there so that you will get a better photo there. Talking about the place that I shoot, it was Oor. It was at Malappally, and there were no lights, already pitch black. I couldn't see where I was going, so I was like the light that I'm using for my rim light, the LC500. So I had that, and I was keeping, like, holding that and going to places and all, because I didn't have my phone there. It was charging. I didn't take my phone, so I was like roaming around with this light, or like pointing downwards, because this is my first time going there, and this place was so freaking beautiful. I didn't take any videos there, the BTS of the place. I was like, we lost track of time while we were shooting the music video. So the place where I was a awesome place for shooting stars, and they were like, literally the sky was full of stars. Like, okay, guys, see this photo. Well, now you know like how many stars were there, and let's get into the shooting part. So you you will need a camera, of course. You can use a mobile phone too, just put this setting into pro mode so that you can manually adjust everything. And definitely you need a tripod for shooting at night, because you will be like scrolling down the shutter speed for seconds, so you can't handheld and shoot it. So if you are like shooting handheld, it will be like super jerky and there will be so much motion blur. So it's preferable, not preferable, there should be a tripod. Yeah, so tripod and a camera. So coming into the settings, you want to keep the ISO as low as possible so that you won't get that much noise, because we'll be like during the production, we'll be increasing the brightness so that you will get more of those little stars brighter. So you want to keep our ISOs low, and I'm keeping my apertures at like f5 to f12 depending on the shutter speed that I'm choosing. So talking about the shutter speed, I'm keeping everything like above 5 seconds. So in this case, I have a note. So I kept the shutter speed at 10 seconds at first for this shot. At f6.3 and ISO 1000. So for this shot, I kept my shutter speed at 10 seconds and aperture at 6.3 and ISO at 2000. So after that, I wanted to experiment with like a little bit more longer exposure so that you will get that light trail. So I like changed my settings into bulb mode so that I can get more than 30 seconds like the shutter speed, right? I wanted it above 30 seconds, so I kept it like 600 seconds. That's like 10 minutes. So I put a timer and shot like 10 minute photo. Like the aperture will be open. No, the shutter speed will be open for 10 minutes and will close, and you will get, so whenever there's a light and it moves, the camera will capture all that in those 10 minutes. So you'll get this. So in this shot, the aperture was at f22 and ISO at 800, and I took few of them, merged it, and this is the final product that I got. So I took 4 photos and I merged them all together to get this. I forgot one thing. When you are shooting with a tripod, you set up the camera and all. Before you press the shutter, right? Even that will get a motion in your camera and will like mess up your shot. So always keep a timer, like 2 second timer is best. Like I normally keep like 10, so I'm like super careful, so I can get some time to move away. Like I move away from the camera, and so that I don't introduce any jerks or motion blur while I shoot. So getting into the editing part, you need to brighten the image up, then reduce the shadows, increase the highlights, the whites, reduce the blacks as much as you can so that you will get a black background. So you don't want any like color cast, like blue colors or anything. So you need to reduce the black so much, and then sharpen it and add some smoothening to it so that you will reduce the noise in the blacks, and this is the final product you get. So hope you guys like this video. If you do, please hit the subscription button, also the like button, and hit the bell icon also so that you will be notified for the future videos. Well guys, I want to say something. 72% of the people that are watching my videos are not subscribed. Please subscribe, it will help me a lot in like putting more content out there, and it's like you giving me appreciation that I'm doing good, and thank you. Wait, that's not how I end. Bye-bye.